Hello, and welcome to ePortfolios 101, what, how, and where to get you started. In this video, you will learn what you need to know to create your first ePortfolio. To begin, let's define what an ePortfolio is. Put simply, an ePortfolio is a personal website. Its purpose is to highlight your professional skills and competencies, as well as showcase your relevant experience with concrete examples. This is accomplished by showing, rather than just telling, what you've done. Your ePortfolio provides you with a space to actively reflect on your projects, work experiences, research, and other learning moments. An ePortfolio also creates a visual context for employers, graduate schools, colleagues, and others with an interest in the work you do. In planning out your ePortfolio, remember that it is as much a reflection of you as it is a reflective experience for you. While every ePortfolio may be unique in its presentation and content, they are all composed of two essential pieces, artifacts and reflection. Artifacts are your displayed supporting materials, and they are included to demonstrate the depth of your relevant experiences and competencies. Artifacts can be any number of things, from research papers and presentations to videos, audio recordings, and other documented projects. With each artifact comes written reflection. Reflections will vary in length and appearance, and also depend on what you want to draw attention to regarding the artifact. Reflections focus on the process of creating the artifact, the outcomes, and your personal growth from beginning to the end of the artifact's creation. However you choose to reflect, remember that your ePortfolio is about you, so grounding your reflection in what you learned along the way is essential. While there is some overlap in terms of what ePortfolios, resumes, blogs, and LinkedIn profiles can do for you, there are some key features that distinguish ePortfolios. With your ePortfolio, you decide how the content will be organized, how you choose to incorporate pictures, themes, colors, and your artifacts to tell your story is entirely up to you. ePortfolios don't have a 1 or 2 page limit, and they can be shared with as many or as few people as you'd like. Each visual artifact and reflection you include provides professional, evidence-based context for your audience that might otherwise be missed. And perhaps most importantly, your ePortfolio's design, purpose, and professional content is up to you and an opportunity to express your creativity. An important note, your ePortfolio does not in any way replace your resume or your LinkedIn profile. Creating and maintaining your ePortfolio would be in addition to the other professional documents and websites you're currently using. To begin creating your ePortfolio, you will want to select the website building platform that works best for you. While there are a number of website building platforms available, we recommend first exploring these free options. My Pages at UNH is a free and easy to use website building tool available to all current UNH students. Wix, Weebly, WordPress, and Google Sites are free platforms to use as well. No free option is strictly better than another. Some options, like Wix and Weebly, offer more advanced features with a monthly or annual commitment, but these are not required. Your preference will ultimately depend on the features you are most interested in using to create your ePortfolio. It is important to emphasize that all of the features you would need to access as a student in these platforms are free. Some platforms, like CarbonMade and Squarespace, require a monthly or annual commitment after a free trial. They offer personalized web domains, mobile app capabilities, and other customizable features. Before you pay anything, however, it's best to know your options and what you want your ePortfolio to include. As always, thanks for watching, Wildcats, and happy creating.